Welcome, everyone. I have a post-interview with Guy again. I'm sure you've been tracking with this progression of what Guy went through. He had stage four cancer, and you know, he was supposed to die like 2 years ago. Was it 2 years ago, Guy?
Yeah, it's 2 years ago.
You were scheduled to die, but you're still around. In fact, I see you right now. You're alive. Just move your hands. I want to see if you're alive.
Yes, I'm alive.
You are alive still.
And so, I'm smiling because I'm alive.
Exactly. It feels good to be alive. I mean, it's amazing. But the question is, why? How did he survive stage four cancer? That's what we're going to talk about today. I finally got another report from you based on your doctor, because you know, some of these doctors, they want to wait for a period of time before they say too many things. But I want to just tell people the findings, the summary findings here, because he had prostate cancer. And it says right here, there's no new suspicious focus on increased radio tracer uptake. Okay.
And my prostate is as a normal size now.
Yeah, right. Right. Incredible. I'm going to pull up your other report. There's a couple of them right here. Look at significant improvement in your osseous. I'm not going to give a bunch of words, but it's basically that means significant improvement in your bone repair, because you had literally holes in your bones from this cancer.
I had six metastases, and five, we don't see anything yet. It's finished, completely repaired. And the one, the T12, we see a little bit, but it's healing. It's still healing.
I mean, this is like just beyond comprehension. And I'm just
not for me, not for me.
Not for you. No, not for me either. But it's just quite amazing for the average person. And for the average doctor, that's like, I mean, your doctor was very, very impressed. And you look very healthy.
Yes, I think.
Now, here's the thing that I want to talk about. We have some theories on why this worked. You know, there's a lot of theories out there, but we have some theories on why this worked. And you connected up with some very, very smart scientists and smart people. And you've done two things. Three things. You've done a lot of fasting. You've changed your diet. And you've taken nutrition. Those three things right there. What's very, very important, and this is really what I want to talk about, is we must do a study on this. We must do a study by a very credible scientist, or basically someone who has done this in the past that's very credible, that knows how to set up a study that can really perform what we want to do. And so we actually have that set up right now, and I want to present this to everyone because we have to make sure that the theory is correct. We want to prove it.
I can tell you that tomorrow I will have a live with Gwenaël Baudimont, Beauchamp Laboratory, who tried on the mice. And he will tell us that three mice lived a lot longer than the other one because we gave them the Scott inhibition.
Okay, so for those of you watching, what he's talking about is that there's already been some other research done on this topic on why it works and what to take in using natural things. I won't get into the details at this point, but I want to let you know that, you know, we have some very good, promising strategies here. But when you actually do studies, you have to start out on mice studies, and you have to not do too many things at once. You have to test one thing, and then you have to do another study, just because there's so many variables. You have, you start with the fasting, you start with nutrition, this and that. So anyway, that being said, we need your help. We want your help funding this study. In fact, if there's not enough people funding it, I'm going to personally fund it myself, because it needs to be done. But the thing that a person or everyone needs to realize is that 40% of the population gets cancer, 40%. And so there's always going to be either a friend, a family member, a relative, or yourself that can come down with this. And we need a solution. We need a non-toxic solution. We need to find one quick, simply because there's a lot of people that I personally know that are just getting cancer all over the place. And so it's very, very important to do this research. Guy has set up a nonprofit organization to fund the research. And for those of you that would love to support this and donate anything you can, that would be great, because we're going to let you know of the details of what we're doing and how it's progressing. And you'll be the first people to know. And it's a good cause. I mean, this helps everyone, including yourself, simply because right now, when someone comes down with cancer, and I know you experienced this big time, Guy, it's scary. And you're like, what do? Someone's telling you this, someone's telling you that. And there's all sorts of opinions. But the problem is most of them are toxic, and some other ones we don't know the long-term effects of these things. So, I mean, do they work for a period of time and they stop working? We really want to figure this out. And so we pulled in some really smart scientists in this study to help us think through the biochemistry of how it works and what we need to block. And so the first part of the study is going to be using natural nutritional things that have known to target the source of fuel for cancer. So we put a link down below. If you would like to help us out and help yourself out, actually, and donate to this research. And so that way we'll put you on a list to keep you updated on that research.
Can I precise something?
Yes.
Before asking for money, I tried since 2 years to ask the French government to pay for that, because in France we have also 200,000 people dying each year, and I think it's the duty of the government to take care of this, not right. of private people. Then it's because they refused to do it, then I'm obliged to ask for help.
Yeah, I just, when you involve the governments, you don't hold your breath, because unfortunately, not only a lot of times the not going to help support it, but they don't want to stop it. So we're going to just basically do it through some very credible people. And we're not making any claims. We're just doing research right now. And so we want to find out what someone can do. But we have to do the studies first, and we have to take these theories and see if they're actually true. And so we will be doing like clinical trial, double-blinded studies on this. So I'm really excited about it, and we want to do this fast, because the faster the better. So if you would like
to save life,
yeah, if you'd like to contribute, we put the link down below. And I just wanted to put this video out to tell you the good news that Guy is still alive, and we have a theory on why that is. But we're going to prove it.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And I will, I already made, you know, that we have an association with 4,000 sick people. And all these people was condemned. They have to die. Mm. And for the moment, they didn't die.
Mm.
I don't know if for everybody it will be like me, because a lot of people doesn't have the courage to do everything I did.
You're right. And so this brings up a really important point. Not everyone can do 40 days of fasting. Now, honestly, if it was a matter of me surviving and having cancer and having stage four, I would do it, but not everyone would. So this particular study, we want to first go after the nutritional protocols to make sure that they work very, very well. And then we can then combine a certain version of your fasting. But you did a combination, but it's we have to figure this out. So very good point.
And perhaps we will not need to have 40 days fasting if Scott work like we, and the four essential, like I call them, work, we can even do only OMAD, one meal a day, and that's it. It will be enough.
So what Scott was, Guy was talking about is the word Scott is a describes an enzyme that actually is feeding the cancer, and then we want to block that enzyme, and there's a lot of data on this, and so we found some natural things that can block it, and then we want to use that. So that's part of the whole concept. I don't want to spend too much time, because normally my videos are like 4 or 5 minutes, and we're already at 14, so I'm not going to take too much of your time, but I'm reaching out to see if you would like to help us. I put a link down below. Donate what you can, and then we'll keep you in the loop. Well, thank you so much for staying with us this long, and we'll be talking to you real soon. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much to everybody.